Hey guys, I'm Thomas Blakemore. I teach, travel, and sometimes try. This is a travel video. I'm currently in Singapore, stood in front of the Merlion, or what was the Merlion. So I checked out the mini Merlion, and today we're going to go and check out some really cheap Michelin star food. Let's go. What a wonderful world. What a wonderful world. How much does it suck to come all the way to Singapore and it still be in restoration? Poor Merlion. So Singapore was originally a fishing village, a very small fishing village at that, and it's obviously boomed. It was originally known as Singapura, which means city of lions. Now fish and lion, that's why we have the Merlion. So we're going to go and check out some of the hawkers, because that is somewhere where you can get cheap food. Apparently there's a Michelin star one as well, so we're gonna see if we can check that out and get some cheap food. So made it to the Hawker Center, and I believe this is where the Michelin star food is. I have no clue though, so let's go inside. So pretty in the sky. I don't know if the whole place is Michelin starred, however, I found a place that does lemon chicken, and that is my favourite food, so it's gonna have to happen. Claire's also bought mango juice, which is a win. So I'm here in the Hawker Centre, and I'm not really sure if this is the Michelin star place. However, lemon chicken wasn't really happening. We all got really confused. This is fried carrot cake, which isn't sweet at all. This was only $4, and this is sugarcane juice, which is really, really good. And that was $2.50. So combined, it was only $6.50. So that's one way of counteracting the significant expense of Singapore. Singapore is known to be the most expensive city in the world. So these hawker centres are fantastic for food, and I cannot recommend them enough. I'm really impressed that I can actually use these chopsticks. Get me. It's good though. Meanwhile, this one is still using knives and forks.
It's a spoon.
And forks.
Spoons
and forks.
There's no knife.
So bad. My parents tried to get me to use these when I was little. Well, you always just use a knife and fork instead. I'm still not convinced that was the Michelin star place. However, it was very low cost, and I would definitely recommend it if you were on a budget. Now, we're going to go and check out Marina Bay Sands. That is a free place to go to. However, we're also going to go and check out one of the waterfall things, I think, and see what that's like. What a wonderful world. So, I didn't expect to be doing this in Singapore. We're in the Art and Science Museum. You do have to pay for this, however, it's so fun anyway. I definitely recommend it. So the thing with these pictures, apparently you can draw the pictures and then scan them onto some screen, and apparently you can see it come up on the screen. Here's Claire's finished model. And then there's mine.
Oh, that's just rude.
This place is incredible. This is one of those Instagram versus reality moments. I was probably the most posy, but it's funny watching everyone else pose. So the Art and Science Museum was absolutely brilliant, and we signed up for this SAMS membership, and that gave us buy one, get one free, so essentially half price for both of us, which I definitely recommend. So come to Gardens by the Bay, and there's two different domes that you can walk into. There's the Cloud Garden and the Flower Garden. So we're gonna check out the Flower Garden to start off with, and then we're gonna check out the Cloud Garden. So let's see. So if I'm completely honest, I'm not really sure how I feel about this. This is a great place to come if you're interested in plants or you're a girl and you want cute photos. I'm neither, if you haven't, can't tell, and I'm not really that keen on it. So we're about to go into the Cloud Forest Dome and hopefully have a little bit more of a better time and it'll be a bit less busy. I don't know, but whoa. The first thing you see when you come in, and it's pretty impressive to say the least. So just finished inside both of the sky domes, and out of the two, definitely preferred the cloud dome. Now you have to pay for both if you're a non-resident of Singapore, and I'm guessing that's because they want you to visit both because they've put the effort into both. We're now gonna go and check out some of the other food places and see if we can actually find the Michelin star place. So let's go on our adventure. So made it to Chinatown. Now I think that's where this Liao Fan Hawker Center is, where the Michelin one star cheap restaurant is. Fingers crossed that's actually where we end up, because we right now are
Marvin, I'm gonna get run over.
Starving. We finally found it. So this is definitely the right place. It is absolutely rammed in here. The food looks incredible. Can't wait to have it. So we've bought three different dishes and two drinks for it to come to a total of 20 Singapore dollars. I have no idea how much that is in US dollars or pounds, but God, I'm impressed. So as you can see, the food is absolutely brilliant. Now, there's not a lot of space to film inside here, so I couldn't really film. But the story of this place is absolutely incredible, and I'll tell you that outside because it's so busy here. So this is the Hawker Cham restaurant. It didn't used to look like this. It used to be a little stall inside the Chinatown complex. Now, it eventually got its Michelin star. You can imagine that when it got its Michelin star, it got a lot busier. Now, it could have done one of two things. One, hiked the prices, or two, just made more. And it chose to do the latter, make more. So from there, it eventually got so popular that he needed a stall like this. The food was brilliant. Was it Michelin star? I don't know. However, I definitely enjoyed it and would recommend it as a good place to go. Now, that's the end of the video here, guys. What a day it has been in Singapore. Done an absolute crazy amount of things. So we're going to then be going to Kuala Lumpur and a range of other things. So Singapore has been absolutely brilliant and I've had an amazing time. It's definitely expensive, but hopefully you've learned some tips to make things a little bit cheaper whilst here. Make sure to subscribe in the corner if you've enjoyed my videos and check out some of the others in the top. I'll see you in the next one, guys. I'm out. What a wonderful world.